It's me, Ahmed Abdelatif, coming to you from speaklikeanegyptian.com. Welcome to this new Egyptian Arabic lesson. Today's lesson, actually, it's very simple notes. Today, I will be telling you 3 points that you should know before start learning Egyptian Arabic. But before we start, make sure to press subscribe and thumb up for the video. And let's start with the first point you should know, which is Egyptian Arabic has no rules. There is no Egyptian Arabic grammar. I know this sounds crazy, but yes, there is no Egyptian Arabic grammar. So what does Egyptian Arabic teachers teach, actually, like me and any other Egyptian Arabic teacher? What do we teach? What we teach you is a common way of dealing with the Egyptian Arabic language. So it's something common. We deal with it through this verb or through this noun. So we consider it as a virtual rule. We consider it as a generalized rule. But that means there are many, many, many exceptional cases. So first thing, that Egyptian Arabic has no rules, but there is a way of dealing with the Arabic grammar that Egyptian Arabic teachers do it as an extra mile from themselves because it's not written in books. Second thing to know is that Egyptian Arabic words have no very specific way to pronounce a single word. For example, let's take very simple two examples. The word and in Egyptian Arabic. The word and in Egyptian Arabic, it can be considered as wa or we. Wa or we. So the word and can be pronounced as wa or we. Same thing for the word tha. That can be considered as or can be pronounced as al or il. Al or il. Which one of them is right? Both of them are right. Both of them are right, and both of them just do the same function with the sentence. So al or il, both are simply the same. Last thing, that Egyptian Arabic is very flexible. What I mean is here, like if you have an Egyptian expression, this single expression actually can mean like 3 or 4 other expressions. It depends on the condition this expression is said. So it's very flexible, and one single expression can mean a lot of other expressions. So these were the 3 points you should consider before learning Egyptian Arabic or before thinking about learning Egyptian Arabic. And that's all for now. Thank you for watching. For private online classes, make sure to mail me at info@speaklikeanegyptian.com or simply WhatsApp me on my number written below. Thank you for watching and see you in my next lesson. Ma'a salama.